Thank you. And then he says, Sound your horn. No, that's too good. そうっすね。
ちょっと気になってみて。
In the pipes come.
I don't know the song either. I know the song.
So bless it to us. So
good morning, everybody. Welcome to our parish here of Our Lady, Mother of Divine Grace. I invite you now to please stand as the remains of Declan Buffet are now arriving at the parish and his family. My friends, in the waters of baptism, Declan died with Christ, and we pray that his soul will be raised to new and eternal life.
Your candles die. Spoke a thousand words last night as his remains were in the house, and
and it's Declan with nothing other than the San Maguire, and he's almost kissing the San Maguire cup, a true dog that he loved his sports, and so the picture has been placed on his remains. You all have your memories, and so we gather them together, and we ask the Lord to be with us now as we begin this Mass. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. May I invite you now to stand as we confess our sufferings. Mindful of our human weakness, our faults and failings, we call them to mind in a moment of silence, asking the Lord to bless us and to strengthen us. We have sinned against him, and we are contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy. Risen Lord, you are the pattern of our life forever. Christ, have mercy. Lord, you are the promise and the image of what we shall become. Christ, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us. May he forgive us for our sins and lead us all to everlasting life. And so let us pray. O God, to whom mercy and forgiveness belong, hear our prayers on behalf of your servant Declan Fay, whom you have called from this world, and because he put his hope and his trust in you, command that he be carried safely home to his heavenly reward, and come to enjoy your redeeming reward. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives, who reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit. You are one God forever and ever. Amen. If you'd like to be seated now, we listen to the sacred readings. The first reading has been read this morning of the Old Testament by Michael.
Thank you.
says. Thanks be to God. I invite you now, my friends, to please stand to greet the Holy Gospel. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Your words are spirit, Lord, and they are life, for you have the message of eternal life. Alleluia, alleluia.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Have faith in God also. You have faith in God, have faith also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would I have told you that I am going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself, so that where I am, you also may be. Where I am going, you know the way." Thomas said to him, "Master, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Once again, on behalf of the family, you are most welcome to this funeral mass. It is with great sadness we're here this morning. It's been a long, long journey for all of them and for the family, and for you, at this very sudden and untimely death of Declan. You know, I was writing a few words, and what do you say about such an event like this morning? It's very difficult to put your thoughts together and try and make sense of this event. But sometimes, I've written our life is interrupted, as we all know, by a knock on the door, or by a phone call, both grabbing our mobiles and fumbling about, trying to answer the phone, and then miss a call. And technology can be so annoying. And, you know, with all this interruption, sometimes our world is never the same afterwards. And you and I know that some weeks ago, mid-July, July 24th, all of our lives, but especially Sally and Porrick and Michael and Mary, and you, Declan's nieces and nephews, and his many, many friends were here this morning, you his friends, work colleagues from Trinity College, the Board of Works, the Department of Social Protection, all you musicians who've come together to pay your own tribute in a magnificent way at this Mass, and you, his 14 friends, all of you from Rohini and beyond, and all of you journeyed with Declan. Your lives, all of our lives, have been interrupted by a phone call or by a visit.